Manufacturing is the essence of what our customers do. What they obviously need is to have a solution for managing their operations in a swift but also very secure and safe manner, so that they know that they can trust the system, that they can trust the partner to deliver traceability, to deliver scheduling regarding who needs to do what in the factory, to have electronic work instructions around that. So it's an essential system within their shop floor, with and they trust these systems in order to drive the overall production. Manufacturing execution systems have been around the last 40 years. You need a system that is providing the reliability while also providing the flexibility to orchestrate all of your operations. Now, what we see is there is a lot of homegrown systems, a lot of IT-based systems that currently manage the shop floor, and a lot of this is getting replaced because of the need to have better support, a leaner infrastructure, a lower total cost of ownership. There is a lot of change in the workforce. There's less people actually available that can be on the shop floor. There's less trained people that are there. Another mega trend is what can we do in order to lower the total cost of ownership? So it's really about having the flexibility to scale up, to move to the cloud is one topic. When we say the move to the cloud, and we have great examples of customers all around the globe, they have increased their productivity, they've increased their flexibility. With our manufacturing execution systems, we are a core piece in the manufacturing process. One element of that is really security. And especially with the trend moving towards the cloud, it becomes essential that these systems are secure. And last but not least, really having the innovation in the form of AI around them to augment the workflows in the factories. For example, if you are working in the aerospace industry and you are working on really complex manufacturing tasks, you might want to look at the details of the documentation, and you want to have an interaction about it, and then you can ask in natural language what is actually there in the documentation. As anyone knows that has experienced the shop floor, they want to have the information they need. So we are introducing low-code capabilities into our Opcenter portfolio with a persona-based approach. So you have a clear view of saying, okay, I'm an operator in a certain industry, and this is sort of the information that I need. The added benefit of it is that we've been able to decrease the amount that you actually need to implement things by more than half. And user experience is really key for those users that don't have the time to search for things. So that's why we offer easy, personalized user experience with Mendix embedded directly into Opcenter. The world is changing, and the rate of change is accelerating. The time to market is decreasing. You see much more flexibility in the production systems. We partner strongly within Siemens to have an overall ecosystem with Industrial Operations X that is really working towards a seamless experience of the whole approach towards manufacturing execution. By having an open ecosystem of different applications that can run physically on hardware, that can run on edge devices, that can run on the cloud. And in conjunction with that, there is virtualization of the PLCs, there's virtualization of a lot of hardware happening. I think it's really the harmony and the intersection of hardware and software that is not just key to my work in manufacturing operations management, because that is the value proposition that we have, that we support from design all the way to the manufacturing planning, as well as the execution and operations, and then also understanding where what kind of data flows back to this. This is a key element that we as Siemens also provide, is to take the customers on the journey towards looking at manufacturing operations management, but really providing a coherent solution with a digital thread connecting all of that.